I'm on now. Okay. So practicing our verse, 1 Corinthians, because I know we're going to have some people joining us online. 1 Corinthians 16:13, we've learned we have to be on your guard. In other words, you got to be ready all the time to make sure you can do the right thing. Okay? Second says, stand firm in the faith. That means, oh, people may try to talk me into doing the wrong thing, but no, I'm going to stand firm and do the right thing. The next part says, be courageous. We don't have to be afraid because Jesus is watching over us. He's taking care of us. He's protecting us. We can be courageous. We don't have to walk around going, oh, 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 I'm afraid all the time. We don't have to be afraid because Jesus never leaves us. Okay? So, Ellie, when you're being courageous, means you don't have to be ever afraid, right? You can be courageous. And the last one says, be strong. And that means if I come over and I say, oh, Micah, I can talk you into doing. Your mama said you weren't supposed to do something, and I try to tell you to do the wrong thing. Micah can be strong and say, no, mama said no. Will he do it? Not quite yet. He's still working on it. Will you? When a kid tries to tell you to do the wrong thing, are you going to do the wrong thing? You're going to say no. I'm going to be strong and do the right thing. Say no and be strong. Be courageous. Be ready. That's what we want to do. We want to be that kind of person. So that's what we're going to be talking about this year. We're going to be talking about the fact that God's word, the Bible. So guys, this is God's word. This is how God teaches us. It's called the Bible. We read it because it helps God, it's way God teaches us.
What?
We learn. What is this called? The Bible. And so we come and we read about the Bible, and we read the amazing adventures in there, and we learn about important people. There was a guy, and I can tell, we're going to have to, you know. Okay. Okay, you know what? Stick it back on quick, because there was a guy in the Bible, and his name was Noah. Now, Noah was already the only guy on the whole earth who did good things. He loved God. He was kind. He was a good guy. He treated people kindly. He was nice. He did the right thing. What was his name?
Noah.
And so Noah was 500 years old. We don't even, that's old. That's older than me even.
Whoa.
Okay? Whoa, that's really old. And God spoke to him, and God said, Noah, I want you to do something different than everybody else. I want you to get a bunch of wood and build a huge boat, a big boat. Whoa. The boat was going to be huge. The boat was going to be, see this whole room? It would be as bigger than this whole room. Clear to the corner up there in the roof. Clear over to that corner. All of this, it was bigger than that. He said, I want you to build a boat. And he was out in the middle of the desert. And the desert's got sand and there was no water. He said, why would you build a boat out here? And God said, build it and I will show you. I want you to build this boat. In fact, I want this boat to be so big that it's got three stories. First story, second story, third story. That's a big boat. Now, that would be a big boat, and it'd be really, he says, I want to take care of you because I'm going to have to clean up the whole earth and all the mess that's here. So he said, I want you and your wife, Mrs. Noah, and then I want your kids, I want your kids, your sons and their wives, three of them, put them in there. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 with mom and dad. So there's 8 people. He says, I want you to be ready. Yeah. But I want something else in that boat. I want animals to be rescued. So I'm going to ask you something here. He said, I want you to get the mama and the daddy of different kinds of animals. So give me one kind of animal that you think went on the boat. Zebras. So it'd be a mama and a daddy zebra. Now, what's another kind of animal?
Baby.
Think about it. Think about it.
Baby giraffe.
Well, there'd be a mama and a daddy giraffe, so they could have families,
yeah,
right?
Baby.
And then, yeah, the babies will come. That's how it works. Moving right along. What other kind of animal? Probably. There's a mom and a dad like that. Okay?
Baby.
Yeah, a mom and dad, and then they would have some babies. Whew, okay, what kind of animal for you? A what? What kind of animal? Zeke, it wouldn't be you, man. What's an animal? How about, what animal? Okay, dinosaurs. But it's probably a mama and a daddy. There would be bears, and there would be what kind of animals?
Gorillas.
Gorillas?
Yeah.
And dogs?
Yeah.
Okay, hang on. I'm right here. You don't have to yell. Okay, I can hear you. What else?
Giraffes.
Giraffes. We said bears and lions, dogs and cats, alligators, cows, pigs. Chickens, what else, people? What else?
Cockroaches.
Snakes? Snakes? Alligators? What? Spiders? Okay, so we've got to put all the others. Now, listen to me carefully. Listen carefully. It's the adults that are having a hard time settling down, isn't it? Okay, how is Noah going to go get all those animals and get them to come on a boat? Because they weren't trained. They would be wild animals. You know what? Noah didn't have to. God brought the animals, and when the boat was built, God, on the day it was the last week before the waters would come, and God brought all the animals onto the boat. And he brought mom and daddies of all these animals and put them on the boat right here. Mamas and daddies all climbed on the boat, and all the animals were there. And Noah looked, and I'm sure he and his kids and his wife were like, wow. All the animals came onto the boat. When they got him on the boat, God had said, now they also have to have food because they would get very hungry. So they put all kinds of grasses and plants, and if they ate seeds and grains and flowers right here, they would put all that on the boat for the animals to eat. So the animals had food, the people had food, and everyone's ready. And then, careful, listen carefully, because it was about time for the rain to start. And you know what? When it was time, they looked around and they wondered what was happening next. They got on the boat. God shut the door. Noah didn't go shut a door. I don't even know if there was a handle on the door. Because God shut the door for them and put them in there safely. Had everything ready to go. And then they heard it. Drip. He already shut the door. Drip. Drip, drip, drip. It started to rain, and they had never seen rain. Then it didn't just start a little rain. It started pounding rain. Then it started raining so hard from the ground, and the Bible says, that's what we read in the Bible, this whole story. The Bible says water even started to come up from out of the ground, and water was coming up from down below, and rain was pouring down from on top until all of a sudden, they felt something. The boat started moving. There was so much water that the ground was entirely covered with water, and the boat started to move. and they started to float. And it rained one day, 2 days, 3 days, 4 days, 5 days. It never stopped raining. 40 days. That's a whole month and another week or so. It rained that long. We would be going crazy. I would want to run outside, and I would want to peek outside. It was raining so hard they couldn't open anything. They couldn't open the door because God had shut the door to keep them safe. Until after over a month of it never stopping to rain, they were floating, and it says they floated high enough that the tallest mountain on the whole earth was covered with water. That's how deep it was. The highest mountain was covered with water. So they're floating up there, and there's nothing to see anymore but water. And they floated, and they floated. And they floated, and they floated, and they floated. And what happened is, 1 month went by, and 2 months went by, and 3 months went by, and all the earth was covered with water. Once it stopped after 40 days and 40 nights of raining, there was still water everywhere. They didn't just go, oh, it's a little over a month. That's a long time. But they didn't then just pop open the door and come out. They had to wait for the water to all slowly go down. And month after month after month after month passed by. Most people understand from the Bible that it was probably almost, listen carefully, it was probably almost a year. How old are you? How old is he?
Three.
He's three.
Yeah.
It would be clear until he turns four before they could come out of the boat. How old are you?
Five.
It would be clear until you're 6 years old before you could come out of the boat. How old are you? 10. It would be 11 before you could come out of the boat. That's a year that passed. He sent out birds to check and see. Nope, they still couldn't land because the water still covered the trees. Yeah? The fishes are the only thing that was able to survive. But fishes weren't doing evil things. Okay? They don't think that way. And so they were okay. But the rest, if you go up the road about an hour from here and you go up in the mountains, you can find an entire skeleton of both a hippopotamus and you can see seashells in the rocks. How did they get there? The whole earth was covered, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And so here are these amazing things that even scientists can show you. So the time came. Hang on. Sit really still because guess what happened next? What? God said it was time to come out. So the boat settles down on the ground and the water comes down. And then they had to wait because it was so muddy. Can you imagine how thick the mud would be? You had to wait for the mud to dry out so you could get out. And they came out onto the land, and they opened the door, and all the animals came out. And Noah was amazed because the whole earth was like cleaned, fresh, and new. And now the animals started going. And I'm sure the giraffes went that way, and the lions went that way. And the bears and the cows and the chickens and all the different kinds of animals went off to find their homes and start having families. And now they're all over the earth covered again. But God said to Noah, because Noah was a little worried, what if God did that again? And God says, I'll make a promise, it will never happen again. Okay? God said he would never make it happen again. He says, in fact, I will promise you. Now, sometimes people make promises and break them, don't they? But not God. Hmm? You like that door, I know. So do I. Whoo! Okay. So here it is. How are we going to trust God to make, he says, I'm going to give you a special signal so you'll know that I keep my promises.
A rainbow.
A giant, have you ever seen a rainbow?
Yeah.
If you've ever seen a rainbow, and you'll see rainbows, you'll go, ah, thank you, God, that you always keep your promises. Every time you see a rainbow, we say, thank you, God, you always, always keep your promises. You will keep us safe. You will watch out for us. You'll never cover the whole earth. Now, there are floods sometimes, but not the whole earth, and he doesn't allow everyone to perish, to die in a giant flood. He doesn't, because he gave us a promise with a rainbow. And every time it rains, he says, oh, the rainbow pops out when the rain stops. So that we remember that God will always start and stop the rain. Okay? Whoa. Now, where did I get that story from?
A book.
What's that book?
Behind you.
It's behind me. The book is, you're right.
No, it's behind you. It's the picture.
It is the picture up there, too. But what is it called? This is what you have to get in your head.
Holy Bible.
The Bible, yes.
Yeah.
Because that's how God teaches us. Some of you guys already know this. But some of you are being very wise, because if someone doesn't know it, they have to learn it, don't they? And that's what we're doing tonight. With some people that maybe don't know what this book is, that it's the Bible, and it teaches us. So when you take home your rainbows that you made, it reminds you that God keeps his promises. When you take home your round circle and it tells a story, it reminds you God keeps his promises. Because what's really cool is this book, the Bible, every time we come here, we learn more about what God did, his great adventures. So tonight, Miss Karen went to a place that made a pretend ark. It wasn't the real ark. It was a pretend one. Do you want to see what that looks like? Mr. David, can we see some pictures? How big that building was? That's how big the real ark was. That's the, Mr. David is up there. It's okay. He can handle it. So watch it. It's like TV. Okay? That's the picture with the ark. Is that big? Look how tiny the people are compared. Keep. Wow. See, there's a big ramp. See, he's moving the arrow. Do you see it?
Yeah.
And you could walk up there and get into that big ark. And there's the circling where the door was that God shut and put him inside there. So let's see what else is in there. Ooh, there's a picture of them. They got to pretend they were going on the ark. Don't they look kind of funny? They look like they were dressed in old times, huh? That was Mr. Rowley and Miss Karen. Okay, check it out. You know, he probably had to make some cages. Because what if the lions came over and ate the chickens? We couldn't have that happening. So they'd have to have some places. God told them to make it 3 stories tall. So you can see how there's an upstairs and a downstairs. Got a few more. Some of the animals. Now, they made some pretend ones to put in there. And so, they had to keep the bears happy for almost a year in there with them. Would you be ready to keep the bears happy that long?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, and then look at what are they doing. They have a big cart, and probably they have bags and bags of food for the animals, like the grain. It took them years. It took at least a full year to get the ark ready and filled up with the food and stuff they'd need.
Yeah.
And all the time they were doing that, people were making fun of them. Because they couldn't believe it. And now, there they are, standing. And what does the rainbow tell us? That God, listen to me, that God always keeps his promises. Say it. God always keeps his promises. Say it again, everybody. God always keeps his promises. That's what it's about tonight, for us to remember that. Okay, so that's a book she brought, and maybe some of you want to see some of those pictures, but it's about time we have to get ready so they can go. We have to be on time. And so tonight, we're going to pray real quick. So will you sit down for a minute so we can pray? Thank you. Thank you. Look at that. Great job. Okay? Let's pray. We pray, that means we're talking to God. Okay? Okay, EJ, we're going to pray right now, okay? That means talk to God. Let's talk to him. And sometimes we do that, we close our eyes so that we're not bothered. Dear Jesus, thank you that you made, helped Noah make an ark. God, thank you that you keep your promises to us, that you made it rain, but then you made it dry. Jesus, help us understand that you are a God that we can read about in this book called the Bible. Thank you for our Bible. And God, most of all, will you help us remember that you always keep your promises. Amen. Okay. So tonight it was important. What I'm going to have you do is just listen carefully right now, because it's time to go. And we want these guys to get home in a timely manner. Okay, so what we're going to do is this. Adults are going to sit still for a minute. The kids have something they have to do. The kids are going to have to go over there and get their craft with their name on it. And then come back. Just a minute. Only when I say go. And then they're going to have to go over to that table and get their circle with their name on it. Okay, so whatever's over there and whatever's over there, that's two things. Now I have one more thing to give to each of you, okay?
Behind you.
It's the Bible. I know. You're keeping your eye on that, okay? I'll have Miss Jenny hold my Bible for me, okay? I thought it would be kind of fun to send you home with a little something fun, a prize. And I thought about, man, I don't really have a bunch of mud to give. You really like to be up close and personal, don't you? Okay, I thought, you know, I can't send a bunch of mud home with you, because that would be a good way to think about the ark and all that rain. Instead, what if I give you some slime? Now, you have to promise me you cannot open it until you get home. Okay, and then parents, I'm sorry. Wherever your mom and dad say you can do it, you can do it. But you want to hang on for a minute and I'll show you? I know Mr. Sam's going to want one too. Slime monsters, and you suck up the slime and squeeze it out. Then I thought that's what it would be like right after the flood. Okay, so everyone, when I wait, oh, you're gonna get one. You're gonna get one, but this is what you gotta do. What? Whoop! Listen to me. You gotta go get one. You gotta go get two, and when you can show me your two papers, you get one of these. Go. You got to go get your stuff. Take them. EJ, take your brother. When you can show me you got both of them, okay, then go get your second thing. And then you can come pick one out. Go get your other thing. Go with brother. Go. You got them. Oh, Ellie, you got yours. Come here. Ellie, you've got yours. You got your two things. You get to pick out a slurps. Here's orange, yellow, green, blue. Pick the color you want. You guys, who else wants one? Well, I've got them. You can have one if you want. Got yours? Take it to grandma. Take it to mom. Yes. Change out. Everyone gets one. Thanks for being with us online. Bye. It's a little crazy here.
I got that.
Okay.